Hi, I'm Jasmine Greenaway, and in this demo, we're going to work through some array methods. One thing to keep in mind is that these are just a small set of functions and methods that work with arrays. There's a lot more, but these specific ones are going to be great for array manipulation, changing the data inside, and things like that. Here on line one, we're going to use array one throughout this demo. In this first example, we're using the push and pop function. So on line 5, we add a string to array 1, and then we print it to the console. Notice that when we use push, we get the new length of the array. So that includes a new value. Pop will return the last item in the array and remove it from the array. So if I print it, I see that that string is now gone. Now let's do the same thing with shift and unshift. So unshift will add the new value, except it adds it to the front. So when I print it here on line 13 and I look at it in the console, I notice that the string is in the front of my array now. And when I use a shift method, it removes the first value from the array. So now that string is gone when I print it again to the console. Moving along to concat, here we've created a new array called array 2, and it has 3 values in it. And what we're doing is just merging 2 arrays together. So we use that array 1 variable that we've been working with throughout this demo and concatenating it to array 2. And what we get is array 1 followed by array 2. So all the values in array 1 show up first, and then all the values in array 2 show up next. On line 21, we do the same thing with array 2. So now array 2's values show up here first, and then we've created an array here in concat to add this array with values 1, 2, and 3 to array 2, merge them together to make a whole new array called new array 2. And then we just print them to the console. And that's what we're seeing here.